Hi, and welcome to Felicious Reviews, a channel where we discuss all things beauty, including makeup, skincare, and sometimes hair care and nails. So if you're interested in any of those, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you can be notified every time I post, which is Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Today, I'm actually responding to a request by a subscriber to list all my favorite moisturizers that do not pill. And this is what the video is going to be about. I know it's something different that I usually do. I'm not going to be reviewing each one of them in general, but I'll just be giving an overview of these products and what I like about them. A lot of these products have been reviewed before, so I will leave links wherever applicable. And other reviews are on my Instagram, so you might want to check that out as well. The link is in the description box below. So let's get into it. I will be listing out around 11 or 12 moisturizers that are my absolute favorites, but I'm not going to be listing them in a particular order, like from most favorite to least favorite or anything. It's just a general list, so don't worry about it. Anyway, so first of all, my most favorite moisturizer is the Vaseline Essential Healing Lotion. I know it's not something high-end or anything. It's completely drugstore, and this is something that is kind of like my holy grail. I've been using this since, I don't know, I think I've been using it since I was a kid. And every time my skin gets a little less than ideal, I always go back to this. This is also my face lotion and my body lotion, so I have to have this. I have at least like three bottles just like this. One in my bathroom, one on my nightstand, one in my kitchen, because I always want to keep moisturizing. And I really love this because obviously it is very, very affordable, but also very, very effective. So if you hear anybody saying that you do for a good skincare or for a good moisturizer, you need to spend a lot of money, don't listen to that person, because if it's working for you, then keep using it. And it doesn't matter how much you spend on something, as long as it is working for you. The next product is CeraVe Hydrating Lotion. I don't have it over here right now, but my sister has it, and whenever I visit her, I'm always going to use that lotion because it's so nice, it's so lightweight, it sinks in so perfectly. It is very affordable as well. It comes in something like this kind of packaging, maybe a little smaller or something, but it is super affordable and super effective, and it's really good for people with dry skin. And of course, all of these products that I'm going to be mentioning, they do not pill, so I'm not going to keep repeating that again and again. So that's a really good lotion as well. I really like how lightweight it is. It doesn't leave a greasy finish or a sticky finish or anything. I feel like it works on multiple skin types, oily as well as dry. So you should check that out. The next product is this COSRX Advanced Snail 92 All-in-One Cream. This is a Korean brand that you might be able to find at Ulta Beauty, but you can find more of their products on websites like YesStyle. I'm going to leave a link for YesStyle in the description box, as well as my rewards code. If you want to try something out, you're going to get a bigger discount if you use my link and my rewards code, of which I do get a little bit of commission. Anyway, so what I love about this product is, first of all, that it comes in around 100 ml quantity, which is rare, because, and it's super affordable. It's 20 something for 3.4 ounces or 100 ml. And that's rare because usually face moisturizers, they come in packaging from around 30 ml or 50 ml, and they're super expensive as well. But this one is so affordable, so much of quantity, and I really love the texture. The texture is like a goopy kind, which I really like. So I guess it's not for everybody, because not everybody would appreciate this texture, but I really do like it. And if you're applying it in the right amount, like maybe one finger dip or something, then it's gonna be really nice. It's gonna sink in very nicely, but it is going to need a bit of time for it to sink in. That's the only thing about it. The absorption is not like instant. But it is really nice. So when, like, right now I've applied it and it's gonna feel a little sticky at first, but after the first 5 minutes or so, it's gonna sink in very nicely, and then you can follow it up with any other moisturizer or sleeping mask or anything else that you might want to use. I have used this I think it's been a very long time since I've started using this. Maybe I think I started in October or something. So it's been a really long time, and this is still so much. Like, I still have a lot of it left. So I really love that as well. It's really hydrating because it has snail mucin in it. I know that sounds gross, but it's supposed to be more hydrating. So it might seem, the texture might seem like it's gonna peel, but if you wait the, like, if you use the right amount and you wait like 5 minutes, it's gonna, that feeling, that sticky or greasy or whatever feeling it is at first, it's gonna disappear really, really fast. So you don't need to worry a lot about it. I've used this as my day moisturizer as well as my night moisturizer. Now I just use it in my nighttime because I feel like it works much better for me for night, because I need a little bit more help during my night routine, because when I'm sleeping I get a lot of I have a lot of transpiratory water loss, so I want to retain as much moisture as possible, and this really helps. The next product is the Summer Fridays Cloud Dew Oil Free Moisturizer, and I've reviewed this very recently, so I'm going to keep it very short. Absolutely love how this is. Again, I really love the texture. It is super lightweight. It's a gel kind of a consistency, so it is super lightweight. It is perfect for people with oily skin who really don't want a lot of you know, thick moisturizer or something. So this is very thin, this is very nice, and you don't need a lot of it for it to do the job. This texture as well seems so airy, so kind of like cloudy, and I really, really like it. I really love it. And if you want to see a full review of this product, I will leave a link over here somewhere so you can check the full review out. Next up, I have Tatcha the water cream, and this is one of my first Tatcha purchase. Before this, I've only gotten like Sephora samples of this of Tatcha. So this was my first Tatcha purchase, and I did not regret it at all. It smells so beautiful. It smells so luxurious. It is, again, it's super lightweight. It feels like you're just putting on water on your skin. It melts right when you put the product on your face. It's gonna melt right in. It's gonna absorb super fast. So it's really great for people with oily skin. Dry skin, maybe not so much, because for dry skin, it's gonna need a little bit more of help. Maybe the dewy skin cream is gonna be a better fit for people with dry skin. I've tried that as well, but I didn't really love it as much. It was a good moisturizer, but not something that I would spend like that much money on. But this definitely is one of my favorites. However, I'm not using it at the moment. I feel like it's a much better fit for me during the summer as compared to the winter, because during the winter my skin gets really dry, and this can be insufficient if you have dry skin. I also really love the spatula that it comes in, and the holder is super useful. And if you've been following me for a while, you know that I love when my products come either in a pump or a jar with a spatula. It just makes things so much more neat and easy. Next, I have Fresh Rose Deep Hydration Face Cream. This is tiny because, again, it's a sample from Sephora. And I absolutely loved the texture that it has. It's also like a gel kind of consistency, but the smell is so beautifully luxurious. This is empty, so that's why I'm not showing the inside. But I really love this. I feel like this is a really good moisturizer when you're, you know, like, a really good moisturizer for your nighttime routine, because it just gives you that very luxurious, very peaceful, very calming kind of vibes. And I feel like it would, and I've been loving this. It doesn't peel. It's also works on multiple skin types. And I feel like it's gonna work equally good for oily as well as dry skin. So try it out, you might like it. I would not be purchasing the full size because that's a little steep for me. But if I do get it on sale, I would definitely go back to this because this is really, really beautiful. And then I have the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Face Moisturizer. So this is not the moisturizer, again, this is a sample. This is not the version that comes in a jar. That's actually, I think it's Ultra Hydration or something, I don't know. But this is actually the one that comes in a pump, in a 1 ounce pump. So I really like this as well. It's also a gel cream and it just, it's almost empty, so I could only get like this kind of product from it, but I really love it. If I think it's the closest thing that I can find to Tatcha, the water cream. This is super lightweight, super airy, super beautiful, and again, it's gonna work good for dry skin as well as oily skin because it's very lightweight, but it's also very, very effective. Although it does smell a little bit like medicinal, if that makes sense, it's like the scent is not the best. It absorbs super fast. It's filled with really good ingredients, really hydrating ingredients like squalane and stuff. So this is a really good moisturizer. It smells a little, I mean, it smells okay, it's neutral, but it smells a little bit more medicinal than it does like a moisturizer, especially an expensive one. So I would not purchase the full size, but if it's on sale, I would definitely repurchase it again, especially because it comes in a pump. And then another one of my favorites is the Drunk Elephant Lala Retro. It's the one that has ceramides in it and a lot of rare African oils in it. I did a whole review of that product as well as a closer dupe for that, so on my Instagram, so if you want to check that out, you can. But I really love the consistency of it. It's like a cream, but it's not heavyweight, it's not chunky, it's not stiff. It's so beautiful and my skin feels like it's been reinforced with a lot of good things like ceramides and lipids and stuff. And it just feels really nice. It's very nice. It has a really nice slip to it as well, probably because it has a lot of it has six African oils. So because of those oils, it has a really nice slip to it as well. So even though it has those oils, it doesn't mean that your skin is going to feel oily. It's going to give you a very replenished kind of feeling, and that is just so good. It's just so good. But the only problem is that it is very expensive. I think it's around like what, $70 or no, 60, I think $60, yeah. And I would not pay that much for a product, but if it's on sale, I would definitely get that again because I love it. And it also comes in a pump top, so again, I really love that kind of packaging. Next up is the Drunk Elephant Proteiny Polypeptide Cream. This again is has a similar full packaging. This is a sample, obviously, but I really love this because this is one of the first high-end brands that I've tried, that I had tried, and it really worked for me, and I saw a visible difference while I was using this tiny little thing. And I think I got this in Sephora birthday thing, so I don't know. I mean, I still have this, it's empty, I still have the box because I don't know, I just like keeping the tiny things. But my point is that this is one of the first high-end brands that I tried. I think this was my first from Drunk Elephant in general, and this is something that really, really worked for my skin. My skin felt so super healthy afterwards. It felt more firm, it felt more youthful, and it has a blend of, I think, a lot of peptides. Actually, it has a lot of peptides, and it's just the consistency, the texture is really supple. It's like very soft, smooth, and supple. It's just basically so luxurious. I mean, it should be because it is like $68. They do have a bigger version of this, I think around like $98. So if you really love this, and I think that would be a good purchase for you, I would not spend that much for anything, but again, if it's on sale, I would definitely get it. Then I have the Kate Somerville Goat Milk Moisturizer. I did a review of this very recently, so you might want to check that out for a full review. But in short, I really love the texture. This is something that sets it completely apart. It's so milky, frothy, so amazing. You know, it feels like you're just putting dairy on your face. But it's really good. I really like it. It's one of the things that has really, really helped my skin during this winter, and my skin was really, really problematic, but it has gotten to a very very nice state now. So this is one of the things that really, really helped. Next up is the Boschia Cactus Water Cream. I don't have it on me right now, but I tried it in a sample, again, like something similar to this size, and that was my first product from Boschia, and it was so beautiful. It was so nice. It also is, I think it's also a gel kind of cream, but it's so beautiful. It's so hydrating. It's just an instant splash of hydration onto your face, and I absolutely love it. I don't think I would pay that much for that again, but you might want to check out TJ Maxx or Marshall's or even Ross, and they have like a really huge tub of this product, so you might want to check those out before you go on to Sephora or Bosch's own site or Ulta Beauty. Check that out, check those stores out, and they have like pretty good things in their stores, and I think I'm gonna pick one up as well. Last but not the least, the Inkeyless Peptide Moisturizer, which was rumored to be a dupe for Drunk Elephant Proteiny Polypeptide Cream. It isn't a dupe. There are very, very little similarities between them. Maybe just the packaging, because that is also a pump top packaging. And also they both have a peptide in their name, but as far as being a dupe goes, they're not dupes. It's not even close to it. It's a good moisturizer on its own, but it's not a dupe for Drunk Elephant. Definitely it isn't. If you want to assess which one is better, I think I would suggest you get Drunk Elephant if you have the budget for it. If not, then Inkeyless is a good alternative, but not a good dupe, if that makes sense. So what I like about that is that it is a cream. It's not exactly gel, but it's also very lightweight. But again, you have to be very careful with that, and in terms of how much you're applying, because it can pale if you are overusing it, or if you are applying like more than you need to, it might pale on you. And I really like it. It has a good I think maybe it has a good like blend of three peptides or something, but it's a really nice moisturizer. Consistency wise and everything else, the Proteiny is better, but the Inkeyless one is also a good product on its own, without any comparison with any other product. On its own, it's a really good product, and I would highly recommend it. I have tried the whole thing, and I would go back to it again. So those were my favorite moisturizers that do not pale, and they are, most of them are actually good for all skin types, except maybe the water cream. All the moisturizers that I've mentioned are really good for all skin types, oily as well as dry. So you might want to check those out. Again, I'm not saying that you should buy all of them, but these are just suggestions from me. These are my favorite moisturizers, and if there's something that fits your budget and you're interested in, go ahead and buy it, and let me know in the comments what your favorite moisturizers are. But that is it for me today. Thank you so much for watching and hanging out with me. Stay tuned for my next video, where I'm going to review Youth to the People Dream Oil, or stick around and watch one of my older videos.